Welcome back to The Witcher 3. I am currently going across all the points of interest around here, just trying to explore and experience the world and hopefully level up enough that I can actually survive trying to find Kolgrim's remains. Now, the chance of me actually being able to survive once I go from here and, you know, see these three points of interest and then go over here, the chance of me leveling up enough just going across here is pretty low, because my current level is level 3. And the suggested level for this quest is level 6. So I'm probably gonna die. But if I can actually do it, then I'm gonna feel pretty damn proud of myself. So let's go to the next point of interest and see what awaits us.
Place of power. Should draw from it.
Oh, come on, Roach, you can't make it up there? You disappoint me. Probably make sure I don't slip off this mountain and kill myself. There does seem to be a hell of a lot of fall damage in this game. Gotta be careful. Jesus, this game is so pretty. I know it looks terrible on YouTube, because vegetation always looks terrible, but man, this vegetation is so lush and just... oh.
I'm too old for treks that long.
You've reached the world's edge. None but devils play past here. Whoa. I didn't even open the map. I did it automatically. Huh. So I guess all this area is... actually, how do they handle that? Do they put up a barrier? Like an invisible barrier? Or... do you just, like, die if you go out of the zone? Looks like it turned me around, so maybe it just kind of puts you back. I'm just gonna run instead of using Roach. I think Geralt could use the exercise. Oh, here we go. Ah, Bandit Camp. Let's go. And I've, the end of the last episode, I believe I increased the power of my Quenzyne at the place of power. Got 25 minutes left on that buff, so let's... okay, ow. Alright, let's go. These people are really low level. Ooh, there goes his arm. Alright, come at me. Oh, too late. Try that again. There we go. Did I just kill him in one hit? Aw, poor guy. Come on, I want to test out my parrying timing. Gotcha. Come on, again. Gotcha. Okay, not bad, not bad. Oh wait, there's another one. No, my ass is gonna remain firmly on my behind. Thank you very much. He had an apple on him. I don't know why that's funny. Fistech? Isn't that a drug? I think that's a really, really addictive, nasty drug, if I remember correctly. overburdened. Oh crap, I've got too much stuff. Looks like you won't be able to run or sprint. Hmm. If you want to carry more, upgrade your horse's saddlebags. I wonder where I would do that. Alright, we gotta dump some crap. I'm thinking the millions of broken swords and cudgels are probably gonna be the first things to go. How do I drop? R to drop. Oh, what? Okay. Thanks. It dropped the first things in the inventory rather than what I was pointing at. Okay. Pick those up again, please. Thank you. That looks like crap. That looks like crap. I think I've got like a million goat hides, too. Oh, what's my weight? 52 out of 60? I don't need to dump anything else. Dump my money. Weighs too much. It's a burden. I've actually only got 8 of these. I don't know if that weight is cumulative or if that's only the weight of one. Let's find out. Oh, damn it. It looks like that's cumulative, so that's the weight of the whole thing. So the goat hides actually aren't all that heavy. Alright, that's fine. I'll just dump the crappy weapons. Looks like the bandits have some booty. Also, a really freaking fancy bed. That thing's gorgeous. Oh, I can't tear out the painting and keep it for myself like in the new Thief games. Sell it on the black market. Ooh. Soaked letter. I like how there's just, like, this crappy cot, like, basically on the ground right here, and then this super fancy bed. Like, this must be where the bandit leader sleeps. He just sleeps here alone, and then, like, all the other guys just, like, cuddle here on this little bed. Alright, let's read that letter. Soaked letter. Soaked in what, though? Blood? So it's not a quest item. That means it's usable? To His Excellency Velarad, Lord Mayor of Azima. Your Excellency, we can wait no longer. The scouts say the Black Ones are already readying their siege equipment. If you wish to escape with your life, please present yourself at the Vizima Temple Quarter sewer entrance tomorrow at the crack of dawn. There's not much room on the boat, so take with you only your closest family and most valued treasures. I shall provide a few men to act as a guard, but not too many, for I do not wish to attract unwanted attention. We shall sail through Black Soul, Stoonwar, White Orchard, and Charsk. From there we shall continue on horseback. Yannick Dellen. Don't tell anyone about your flight, we do not wish to arouse panic. I have no idea what this is really about. I scout see the Black Ones are readying their siege equipment, so they can't wait. They can't wait to do what? If you wish to escape with your life... Huh. I don't know, I don't really understand the context on that. Let's go see if there's anything else around camp. Oh Jesus, there's so many crafting ingredients. Okay, we're good. On to the next spot. What if this is another bandit camp? It's a dead person. It seems too easy. What killed them? Is there something bad around here? There's things over there. I don't see them on the map, though. I guess they're far away.
Strange.
Yes? Any more insight you'd like to offer, Geralt? Why is it strange? I mean, I agree it's strange, but... Glyph. Ooh. Spy's notes. Quest item. It's... wait. I thought it's a quest item. How come it's not in quests?
I don't get it.
Now it's a common item? Okay. 15th day of observation. Back at the camp, brought in heaps of plunder, mostly armor and weapons, but this time a sealed chest, too. Towards dusk, a man delivered rations of food and drink. Messenger arrived in the camp before dawn, caused quite a stir. They immediately organized a group to transport the chest. After dusk, I'll try to track down where they carried it to. Didn't move the case that far away, just to the abandoned hut near the old mill. Set up a watch, so I wasn't able to get closer. Every man in the camp has been drinking since yesterday afternoon. If we attacked now, we'd obliterate them. Too bad the commander only sent one man, me, to this outpost. I'll try to sneak in tonight. If fortune smiles on me, perhaps one man will be enough. I guess not. Abandoned hut near the old mill. Where would that be? Where's the old mill? Oh, wait. There's a mill. Huh. I guess we should go check it out, shouldn't we? Let's see, is that actually the next question mark? I think it is. Huh, it is. Alright, let's go check it out. Got some wolves to take care of first, though. Let's go. Woof woof, motherfucker, come on. Okay. 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 I need to keep backing off until I get my Quinn back. Hold on, F to swallow. Okay, let's do that. Jesus Christ, they do a lot of damage! There. Alright, that didn't work long enough. This is a fucking huge pack. I need to swallow again. That's R. Actually, let's do that too. Oh god, is there more? There's more, I don't think they've seen me. Oh. Wait, are those wild dogs? Hold on, let's loot these bodies first. Yeah, my toxicity is pretty high after all that. Those are kind of high level, I think some of them were like level 5 and I'm only level 3. Another kind of big pack. Looks like, according to the minimap, there's two over here. Let me see if I can get these. Oh wait, they're wild dogs. Yeah.
Come on.
Level 1, no problem. Poor things. Look at... it looks like they've... bad stuff is... like, really bad stuff has happened to them. They're just completely covered in... I guess scars? Or is that some sort of disease? I don't even know. Doesn't look pretty, though. Is that a horse? I swear I just saw a horse. Oh, yeah. Whoa, there's wild horses? Oh, hey. Stop scaring the horses. Kind of feel bad killing them. The way they whimper. Yeah, I wonder if... Did they just run away from you? Can you mount them? Oh, hey, you can! Oh, yeah. I guess they would buck you off, wouldn't they? Don't you buck me
Let's
off!
Go.
I wonder if there's a way to tame them. Oh, that's funny. Well, I'm so close, I might as well just run there myself. Nay! Nay! Okay, so... Oh, there's a dude in there. He just came out. We'll flail your skin. Oh shit, he's a level 7. Okay. I need to be careful.
Don't let him catch his breath!
Die.
Fucking bastard!
Okay, that wasn't too bad. There's a bunch more where that came from, though.
Don't let him catch his breath!
Come on. Yes. He's the only one that saw me. Bit of the crossbow. That didn't feel too good. It seems like doing the dodge is actually pretty effective. Not the roll dodge, but the other one where you kind of just like sidestep. It seems like it's effective to do that even when you're not avoiding a hit, but just to kind of get around the back of the enemy to try to break through their blocks. Just try to break through them blocking your attacks. It seems pretty effective. Not to mention, it just looks really cool. Like, fancy footwork. Ooh, is this the chest? Seems like some good stuff. This might be it. Ah, I'm overburdened. Bah. Take a look what we got. I think I got some new armor that I might want to use. Not bitter. Well, it's the same as what I've already got, actually. Except slightly better condition. Worse. 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 Yeah, nothing else to really use. Alright, let's dump some of these crappy swords. I need to go sell all my crap at a merchant at some point. It's been a long time since I've been to a merchant. Ooh, looks like I can explore down there. More treasure? Aha! Wait, I can't unlock it? I don't have the key? Balls! Where do I find the key? It's gotta be around here somewhere. Maybe it's on one of the bodies and I missed it. Let's check. Oh, I can go up the windmill? Oh, sweet! Let's go check it out. Oh, no! Oh, wait. Maybe... Oh, damn it. Oh! Never mind. Am I supposed to be up here? Locked. Well, fine then. Yeah, I don't know where the key is. Could be in one of these other buildings, I suppose. So I've checked out these. Let's go check out these. Wait, what? What's going on here? Just this, like, splayed bloody body parts just coming out of the stone. That looks really fucking weird. And disgusting. Can I burn that? Nope. There's not gonna be a key in here. Sorry, sir. Didn't mean to stand on your dead body. Jeez, talk about disrespecting the dead. Is it locked? I guess. It looks like there's literally nothing inside. I guess you're not meant to get inside. So yeah, no idea about the key. Let's go die trying to find Kolgrim's remains. Mm-hmm. You know, I better actually meditate first. And, what is this thing? I forgot what kind of a entity it is. Spectre? No, it's a type of spectre. Was it an Unwraith or a devil? Oh, it's gotta be a devil by the well, right? Right? No. Yeah? No, I think it's gotta be a Unwraith. Let's see if I can make spectre oil. Cursed oil? Need Arenaria. Still haven't found any. Oh hey! Cat makes a return. I remember using these so much in the original Witcher. Gives you night vision. I thought I'd gotten rid of them. And white honey. Clears toxicity and cancels all active potion effects. Alright, let's go.
Magic. A place of power.
So just a plain wraith, huh? I didn't kill it. Did I? What happened to it? I don't think I killed it. I'm confused. I'm coming, Kolgrim. That was actually not as hard as I thought it'd be. Oh, Jesus. Just added a bestiary entry right now. Let's go check it out. Finish all your business before you die. Bid your loved ones farewell. Write your will. Apologize to those you've wronged. Otherwise, you'll never truly leave this world. Ah, so they're unsatisfied spirits. Clerics and scholars are forever debating whether spirits do in fact journey to another world after death. One where eternal joy or suffering awaits. Both groups agree, however, on what happens to spirits who, for one reason or another, remain in our world after their body breathes its last. They transform into wraiths. To hear their mournful howls, one can surmise this is not a fate to be envied. Yurden and Quinn, and Spectre Oil, of course. Okay, so similar to the Devil by the Well, right? Yeah, pretty much the same, except with the addition of Quinn as being one of their weaknesses. Okay, so it seems like I can take them really no problem. I don't think I need Spectre Oil. Or Yurden. Let's liven this place up a little bit. If I could hit the hotspot, please. There's even one on the ground. Ooh, magic item. Ah, damn it, I'm overburdened again. I really need to sell my crap. Yeah, these are kind of heavy. I'm gonna dump them. Actually, wait, this might be better than... It seems significantly better than what I have. Yeah, look at that. It's a lot better. Ugh. That might be the old item that I didn't want to put on because it didn't look good. I'm not feeling the style, but... Alright. Let's get rid of rusty swords. Alright, looking pretty good on weight now. I just don't feel like a witcher anymore. Ooh. Letter from Witcher Kolgrim. And I believe that's the last diagram I need. Yeah, there we go. But that sword is pretty damn good. Check and see if there's anything else down here. I think that is it. Yep, looks like it. Alright. Check out the new stuff I got. That'd be this. Cavalry gauntlets. Same armor. Resistance is a little bit less. Yeah, not really any better. Pretty much the same. Actually kind of worse, because it's actually heavier. Okay, so what happened to the quest? I think it's just done, right? Yep. After a short investigation, you managed to acquire diagrams for every element of the Viper School's famous equipment. I learned the story of Kolgrim. Well, not really, because I haven't actually read it yet. But let's go do that. Let's see what happened to Kolgrim. I mean, we already kind of know the outline, but... Let's see the specifics. I guess it'd be here, right? I don't see it. Oh, here we go. To Ivor Evil Eye, Master Witcher of the Viper School. I've now found all the legendary diagrams once belonging to our order. Certain complications have arisen, however. On the way back to our keep, I stopped to rest the night in a village in the Temerian borderlands. The blasted peasants decided to make me into their scapegoat and accused me of kidnapping some beekeeper's brat. They took me into the local lordling's castle for interrogation, during which they found and confiscated one of the diagrams. But do not fear, I will get it back. They did not find the others. I've invoked Temerian common law and demanded a trial by ordeal, instead of submitting to the whims of this baronet. My request was granted, and tomorrow I am to cleanse the baronet's family crypt of wraiths. I expect this will prove little trouble. Perhaps I will already have returned to our keep by the time you receive this letter. Light the furnaces. We'll have some forging to do. Poor Kolgrim. God, if he died from these wraiths, given how easy it was for me, then he must have been a level 1 witcher. Noob.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
I really still don't want to leave. Ah, so pretty. I probably should go fix all my equipment though, huh? Yeah, so I've got no more quests left except the main one, which is gonna make me leave this place. Let's see. So it looks like this is the starting map, right? Yeah, this is like the limit of White Orchard, so it looks like I've kind of been most places, actually. Yeah, I really have actually been to most places. Looks like there's a couple things out here. Let's go check them out.
Come on, Roach.
What do we got? Monster nest. Gotcha. Alright, bring it on. You guys are easy. See if I can take out the nest before they come for me. Where do I put the bomb? Where's the thing? Where's the hole? I don't see the hole. Oh, here we go. Oh, I can't do all in combat. Okay. That's it? Just two of them? No biggie?
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
Oh. Hello there. You can really get a lot of ability points by going to these places of power. I should probably spend them, but... eh. Alright, you know what? Let's go check out this place in the water, and then let's go here and, like, repair my equipment and stuff, and sell all my garbage. Let's go diving! I feel hot.
Long way.
Yes, thank you for automatically opening the map. I didn't need that. I was going the right way. Thanks. Something's here. Wolves. Oh, Jesus. Well, this is going terribly. Warg. Okay, well, should probably always watch where you're diving. I meant to sink into the water gracefully, but instead I almost killed myself. Fishies! Whoa. Whoa, what? The fuck is... what are those? These are... they're... I saw enemies on the minimap, and I see stuff going around. Okay, hold on. I need to meditate first. Can I fight underwater? I can't take my swords out. I don't know how this is gonna work. Oh. Hold on, I think we need to stay here for a minute. Just enjoy the view. Okay. Yep, there's something under the water. Can I please get on this? No? Okay, there's stuff under the water, it's fucking following me! I can't see it. Oh, fuck. Oh, what are those? I don't like this. This makes me uncomfortable. If anybody's scared of sharks and stuff from when they're a kid watching Jaws, like, I'm not super afraid of water, but I'm afraid enough that when I know there's something chasing me and I can't see it underwater, it's really fucking terrifying. What are those mermen? Are those murlocs? Mergurgle? Alright, let's see if they'll follow me to shore. Oh fuck, they're level 10 drowners! They're better at swimming than me! Go up! Oh shit. Wolves. No, don't go back. I didn't mean to do that. Can they attack me underwater? They must be able to. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh. Oh. Let's see. Okay. Okay. Yep. They're really not gonna follow me, are they? Come on. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, come on. Come on. Come on. Son of a... Ah. How are you supposed to get that? I mean, I'm assuming... Spoils of war. Yeah, I'm assuming there's like a chest on the bottom of the ocean or something. Okay, let me try something. I'm gonna heal again. God, I'm gonna be doing this at night, it's gonna be even creepier. Oh, fuck. Alright, so I can swim faster than them if I stay on the surface, so I'm gonna gather them up, and I'm gonna bring them far away by swimming on the surface. And then I'll come back and dive really quickly. Alright, let's get all three. Or all four. Apparently there's four. I'm just looking at the minimap, it's terrifying. Just red dots. I'm really not that much faster than them. And they're not gonna follow me too far. Alright, now's my chance. Here we go. Okay, okay, okay. Dive! Go! Fuck! Oh, oh, I think we're okay. Did I get it? It looks like it's, the icon is not bright on the minimap anymore, so I think I got it. What did I even pick up? I think I saw trousers. This better be some damn good trousers. Hunting trousers. Okay, yeah, those are actually pretty good. They have twice the armor. And that's with them in worse condition than my current armor, actually. They're also way, way lighter. Okay, yeah. I picked up something else too, but I don't know what it was. Who knows? Alright, that's enough adventure for one day in the water. Let's go here and repair my stuff. The world of the Witcher is a dangerous one to swim in. Used to be dudes here doing push-ups. I guess everybody has to sleep at some point. Excuse me, I'm just going to gather these plants in front of you.
Are you here to spy or haggle?
Why not both?
I'd like you to craft something for me.
Alright, so I've never crafted before. Let's see what we can make. Apparently this craftsman sucks. Can't make any of these damn ingots. Craftsman level's too low. Lame. Is there anything you can craft? Refined silver ore? Wait, so this turns hardened timber into a haft. I don't know what that is actually used for. But let's see. Whoa! Required level 12. No, Jesus Christ, that is a high-level weapon. It does like 4 times the damage of my current one, but I can't use it for a long time. What about this one? Oh, this one I actually can. Oh, and it does really good damage. Increases sign intensity. Bonus experience from monsters. Okay, I really want to make this. Yeah. Yeah, let's make this. What do I need? I need one more silver ingot. Okay. Silver plate. Silver ingot. What am I missing? I need 3 more silver. What about this? No, that's not what I want. That uses silver to make it. I wonder if I can make it from stuff I already have, or if I need to purchase more silver directly. Let's try to buy. Or maybe I can dismantle? Like, what if I just use it on a random thing? Wait. Oh, this is stuff that can be dismantled. Yeah. Items are shown here. That shows you what you can recover. You have to pay to dismantle. Enter. Okay. So let's take a look at the weapons. Yeah, what will this turn into? Iron, iron, iron. Steel. I need silver. Nah, none of them turn into silver. Ooh. Can turn silver ore into silver. That's handy. Let's do that. Alright, let me see if I can buy 2 more silver from him.
Show me what you're peddling.
Ooh, here we go. Okay, should be able to craft it now. Right, I need to make the ingot. Here we go. And if I'm not completely incompetent, I do believe, yes, here we go. Cool. It even takes venom. That is so cool, a sword forged from venom. Beautiful. Let's make this too, just cuz. Now what about this? Oh, just one iron. Oh wait, but I'm missing the emerald. The iron ingot I could probably make no problem. Let's see. No, apparently not. I need iron ore. I have no idea if this is interesting to watch. I've never done this before, so I'm just trying to show you some of it, so at least you get an idea of what's going on. I might cut this stuff out in the future, I'm not really sure. Yeah, it looks like all I'm making for now. Okay, so if I want to sell my junk, how do I do that? Like, how do I do it quickly? Because I've got so many freaking items, it's not even funny. Oh shit. There's no sell all junk button, is there? Nope. Oh wait, I can just straight up purchase emerald dust. Oh. I can't even afford it. Never mind then. Alright, well it looks like I'm gonna have to manually sell all my junk, so I'm gonna do that and I will be right back. Okay, so I went ahead and sold mostly just old weapons and armor that I didn't need, which has taken out most of my weight. That stuff is seriously heavy. And gave me about, like, 300 orins or so. Also just replaced out my silver sword with the new one that I just crafted, which is absolutely beautiful. And I also put in this sword to replace my steel sword. I just had this and it does a little bit more damage. Very similar to my old one. 35 armor piercing instead of 38. Plus 9% critical hit damage bonus. So pretty similar, but it's in a much better condition. My current steel sword has a condition of 5%. Ugh. So I'm just going to sell these old ones now and repair my current stuff up to 100%, and then I think we're done.
Are you here to spy?
Show me where you're peddling.
Alright, how much does it cost to repair? 26. To go from 74% to 100%, that's not bad. I can also repair all, which honestly I probably should do. Yeah, I'm just gonna repair all. Okay.
So long.
Alright, got two new swords. Everything's repaired.
Barbarians.
Plenty of room in my inventory. I do believe we're ready for some more adventuring. I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.